everyone, and welcome back to Deployment Guy, the channel designed to help you navigate the world of Microsoft Intune and modern endpoint management. All right, so Microsoft just introduced us to Enhanced Device Inventory Ignite 2024. It's a great new way to get even more detailed info about your devices, like hardware specs and software insights. Today, I'll walk you through what it does and how to set it up. So let's dive straight in. Okay, so the first thing we're going to do is go to Microsoft Intune. We'll select Devices, and then under Windows, I'm just going to pick a random device. So I'll select this top one here. And if we look under Monitor, we can now see we've got Resource Explorer. And if we click into this, we've now got various bits of hardware that we can inspect. Now, you will notice that if we click into these, as it stands, we do get this message about no data found. Now, the reason behind that is that before we can get this data, we need to set up and configure an agent on the device itself. And if we click on the link up here, it's going to tell you exactly how to do that. So you can see here the properties catalog, device inventory, the prereqs, support platforms, how to use. But the bit we're interested in is this bit here, how to create the actual profile. Now, I will quickly show you how to set this up. It's pretty easy. So we'll select Devices, Windows, Configuration. Select Create, New Policy. Platform, Windows 10 and later. Now on the profile tab, you'll notice we've got a new option now called Properties Catalog, whereas previously we had Settings Catalog and Templates. So select Properties Catalog and then select Create. We'll give it a name, so we'll call this Windows Device Inventory. Select Next. Now you'll notice this looks very similar to the Settings Catalog, and it is. So we'll select Add Properties, and in here you can see all the catalog items that we can select. So we'll select each of these. You can expand these if you want to and just select individual bits. So we'll carry on going through. I think for the purpose of this video, I'm just going to select everything. So we'll take these. And then select. And from here, if you want to remove any of these afterwards, you can do, just press the little minus button at the side. Now, obviously the message in the middle, that's quite important. It does say refresh every 24 hours. Now, I will pre-warn you, this is a slow process. Don't think that once you push this out, you'll instantly get data, because you won't. Okay, so we'll select next on that. Under Assignments, I'm going to deploy this to a couple of groups. So I'll type in Windows, and I'll do it to the teacher devices and student devices. Okay, select Next on that, and then Create. Just give this a bit of a refresh. Yep, then we can see a Windows Device Inventory. It's now been created and deployed out. Okay, so I've nicked out, had lunch. It's been about an hour and a half, so technically, some of these devices should have synced by now. So if we go and check back in with these, back under Windows, and I'll select the device that I was checking earlier on, which was this one. If I look under Resource Explorer now, and let's just select Battery, you can see it's still showing no data found. And the same for pretty much everything else in there. Now, as I already mentioned, it's a really, really slow process, and you won't get this data instantly, but there are signs. So we open Task Manager, and we scroll down under Processes. You can see we've now got one. Oh, where's it gone? There it is. Inventory Service. If we expand this, you can see there's a service running in the background called Microsoft Device Inventory Agent. So we'll quickly open Services. Give this a few moments. Yep, there we are, Microsoft Device Inventory Agent. So if we go into the properties of this, you can see the startup type's automatic and it's currently running. So the actual install location for the agent is, I think it's program files. So let's open that. So we'll go under C. program files, and yep, there you can see it, Microsoft Device Inventory Agent. We click into that. This is basically just the folder where the agent installs. So as I already mentioned, it's not a quick process. It really isn't. In some environments, I've seen it take less than 10 hours. In others, it's been more than 10 hours. I've spoken with people who say that it can take up to 24 hours. So unfortunately, it's just a case of sitting tight, being patient, and eventually the data will start trickling into Intune. Okay, so it wasn't a full 24 hours, but to be on the safe side, I did leave it overnight. So if we go back into Intune now, and we select the device that we selected previously. So under Windows, and I think it was this one here, so we'll select that again. And this time, if we go under Resource Explorer, we'll select Battery. There you go, it'll tell you design capacity, the full charge capacity. I'm guessing this is a slight indicator on the overall battery health. BIOS info, again, it'll tell you the manufacturer of that, the version, etc. CPU, yep, 64-bit processor, 4 cores, and it's an Intel one. Under disk drive, if we scroll across, it tells you it's by SanDisk, and it's 128 gig, or 125. Encryptable volume, it's currently not locked. Logical drive, if you've got multiple drives in your device, they'll all be listed here. Memory info, yep, there we are, 8 gig of RAM. Network adapter, now there's a few different manufacturers in there, that's because I've been using external ones on this device, because there's no onboard NIC. OS version, if we go in there, we can see the build version, and if we scroll across, yep, Microsoft Windows 11 Education. System enclosure, not really much in there. Time, tells you the time zone of the device, TPM, yep, 2.0, and it's activated, and it's by Intel. Video controller, yep, it's an Intel UHD Graphics 600. And under Windows, Quick Fix Engineering, I quite like this, it tells you all the hotfix KBs that have been installed on the device. And if we go back to a different device, so I'm going to select TDG Client 01, because I know this is a virtual machine. Under Resource Explorer, again, if we select Battery, it's showing no data, that's because it's a VM, it's on a desktop somewhere. Again, select under all these items, and it shows you all the information there. So I do think this feature will prove useful for some things, but I am hopeful Microsoft will still expand on it a little more. It would be pretty cool if we could do something, say, with filters or dynamic groups, based off the data that has been collected. So there we have it, that's Advanced Device Inventory. If you found the content of this video useful, please do give it a thumbs up and subscribe, as doing so really helps me grow my channel. Until next time, thanks for watching, and hopefully see you again soon.